Hello everyone, I'm Jasnoor and we're starting with the fabric painting workshop. So for this first video, I'll be telling you about the materials that we need. So we require fabric paints. So for fabric paints, you can always use acrylic colors, which are by Fevicryl, or any other acrylic colors, but you need to use these bottle colors. Don't use the tube ones because they are a little thick and it's very hard to get the exact consistency what we require for fabric painting. So now, there are some very important colors that you should always have, like green, yellow and blue. If you have these three shades, you can make numerous shades out of these. So to start with, you can just take a pack of six of these or something like pack of 10, like what I have right now. And there are so many other paints also. So basically these have more than 72 shades. So you can just decide what kind of painting you want to make. It's just a small painting or you're painting some bedsheet kind of a thing. Accordingly, get the shades. They have all ready-made shades. You don't need to even make. Like they have these beautiful pastel shades. They have neon shades. And the basic shades are of course available. So select your shades accordingly. Then you also require brushes. Now brushes play a very important role. There are two different kinds of brushes we all know. Like the flat brushes and the round brushes. These are the flat brushes. These are the round brushes. So flat brushes really help when you are giving, you know, sharing strokes, and round brushes are important for filling up, for making the outlines. Whichever you have more control, you can use. But we would require some thin brushes like 0, 000, 00, 1 for making outlines, for giving the shading strokes. And for other parts, you can use a little thick one according to the design you are choosing. So I have some brushes, like you can just choose few numbers according to your requirement, but it should include some very thin ones and a little thick ones also. Then of course you require fabric to start painting on. You can take any plain cotton fabric, that is what it works the best. Don't use synthetic fabric because the paint tends to spread onto that. Then another important thing is that you are never supposed to add water to these acrylic colors, because if you add water, the color is going to spread on the sheet. So you have to add this medium for transparency and watercolor effect. So basically this helps in getting you the exact consistency of the color. In case you find that your color has dried or it's a little thick, you can add medium to it. Do not add water. If with medium, the color does not spread. So this is very important thing. You should always have it handy. Then I would also recommend you to have some sheets when you start with this workshop, because directly you cannot be drawing everything on the fabric you have. You should first start with making it on the sheets. So these are the basic materials. Other than that, if you have something like these embroidery hoops, these would really help, because these help in tightening the cloth. In that case, the color becomes more long-lasting and it's easier to paint because there are no wrinkles in it. So you can use any number according to the design. If the design is small, you use a smaller hoop. If the design is big, you can use a bigger one. So this is all about the basic materials.